The News 8 Storm Team Forecast with meteorologist Matt Moore.
Well, it really was a damp and dreary way to start off your weekend out there across the entire Susquehanna Valley today. Had a little bit of light rain shower activity earlier on this afternoon, and as we head into the evening hours, the rain showers have pretty much ended. However, we are starting to see visibilities dropping across the Susquehanna Valley as some fog and misty conditions are really starting to set up here. But we're looking at super Doppler 8 right now, and really no precipitation to speak of, at least now at this hour. But over the past couple of hours, we did have a little bit of light rain activity kind of push on through, especially eastern portions of the Susquehanna Valley here. It's passed over the past three hours. And you can see really just kind of moving quickly off to the east. But what's really happening now is we're already starting to see the misty, foggy conditions continuing to get worse across portions of the Susquehanna Valley. And one of those places would be here in Harrisburg. We're looking live on our sky cam here. You can barely see the river in the background, just barely make out there's a bridge running across the river. But for the most part across the region, really starting to see those visibilities come down. In Harrisburg right now, we're at 38 degrees. It feels like 33. We're seeing the winds pick up just a little bit out of the northwest at around 6 miles per hour. And as we head throughout the rest of this evening, here's what you can expect. 35 to 39 degrees, pretty much in the upper 30s for the most part. Cloudy and damp, patchy fog and drizzle out there. Even an isolated shower is possible this evening. But then going to tonight, that cold front will push on through and it'll help kind of clear everything out. However, in the early nighttime hours, we will continue to see the mostly cloudy conditions, patchy drizzle, and maybe a stray shower or two out there. But some clearing will be taking place later on and we'll see a low of around 30 degrees. For tomorrow, that's when the sunshine returns, but we'll have to wait till the afternoon hours. The morning, maybe a few clouds out there, maybe some patchy fog as well early in the morning, but then turning mostly sunny, breezy, with winds increasing 10 to 20 miles per hour, but it will be seasonal for this time of the year into the low 40s. Now, speaking of seasonal, today was below average for this time of the year. 40 degrees of the observed high at Harrisburg International Airport, and we did pick up about 4/100ths of an inch of rain at the airport and elsewhere across the Susquehanna Valley. It was pretty much that light drizzle, kind of patchy fog out there. And is looking at temperatures right now across the region, basically in the mid to upper 30s, some spots in the low 40s, 42 right now in Lancaster, seeing 36 in Lewistown. But our temperatures are beginning to cool, and as there's a bunch of moisture in the air, we're going to start to see that fog beginning to increase across the region. And because of that, we're going to start to see some visibilities dropping. 1 mile right now in Lancaster, but we're half a mile in Coatesville, so some denser fog, misty conditions farther to the east. A little farther to the west, though, seeing a little bit better visibilities, but I'm expecting pretty much everyone to get into that foggy conditions as we go into the evening hours and into tonight. But on Super Doppler 8, everything is quiet, not seeing any showers at this time. Just off to our east, though, seeing that system developing off the coast and moving off to the northeast. And we're also seeing a cold front that is going to swing on through the Susquehanna Valley as we head into the nighttime hours tonight, probably during the early overnight hours. But again, some showers just to our south and even a little bit of snow shower activity up here around the Detroit area. And that's basically we have an upper level low that's just spinning just off to the northeast or northwest, rather. A dying cold front will move on through as we head into the nighttime hours. This coastal low will continue to strengthen. But then as cold front pushes through, we'll see northerly flow as we go into tomorrow morning. That's really going to help everything clear on out of here, bring out the sunshine, especially as we go into tomorrow afternoon, and this high pressure will be building in from the west. Now, that's going to continue as we go into Sunday night and into Monday morning and Monday as well. But then our focus turns to our next storm system, which is going to be a blizzard for some parts of the plains, yet another blizzard, the same spots that actually saw a blizzard just a couple of days ago. And it will continue to move off to the northeast and maybe bring us a little bit of wintry weather. But we're leaning more towards rain. So again, as we head through the rest of tomorrow, breezy conditions, a high of around 42 degrees into the mid 40s by Monday, maybe a mix quickly changing over to some rain by Tuesday. But then as we head into Wednesday, looking like some flurries, and the flurries are going to last as we go into the later part of the work week. But breezy conditions will be picking up even as we head into the weekend.
So, well, that's better than rain.
That's better.
All right. Thank you, Mike.